Tozer. Boy, that sun. It is bright.
And it's not even warm yet.
Okay, maybe it's a little warm. When I stop, you know, to think about what I'm doing, it changes the way that I approach what I'm about to do. Because if I take the time to regroup, refocus, restart, then I'm allowing God to invade my time domain or my time space and to turn my attention away from the things that could be distracting, like the heat of the sun or the mosquitoes, if we had them. Speaking of which, they must be coming. Yeah, I better think about that ahead of time. But when I take a moment to pause, as in the Psalms, they use the word S-E-L-A-H, Selah, for a pause. You know, it's like a note. But when I pause to take a deep breath, when I breathe in, it's as though God comes in, says, okay, I can take it from here. Will you yield? And for me, the answer is yes, please, take over, God. Is it for you? Do you stop for a minute when you're about to do something, even if you already know how to do it, and say, okay, Lord, you take over? You see, that's the way it used to be in prayer, was that people would stop and talk to God so that they would be focused on the right thing to do, to say, and to be. But now prayer is just kind of like, God, I'm going to go do my own thing, so let me pray, so you're going to honor it, of course, right? Yeah, okay, we got it, good. Don't bother talking to me, just let me pray and get it over with, and that way I can start doing my thing. That's not what God wants. The Lord, if He is Lord, desires interrelationship, communication, a response from Him speaking to our heart as we share with Him what we want to say. We need to listen to what He would say. And that's what your devotions are about. In devotional, it teaches us how to use our emotions and our devotions and the Word of God and the Lord speaking to put in perspective our day and to walk with Him so that we could hear His voice. Wrong choices may imperil our freedom. Thou, therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is Christ Jesus. 2 Timothy 2:1. There's always danger that a free nation may imperil its freedom by a series of small choices destructive of that freedom. In the realm of religion, right choices are even more critically important. The casual indifference with which millions of Protestants view their God-blessed religious liberty is ominous. Being let go, they go on weekends to the lakes and the mountains and the beaches to play shuffleboard and fish and sunbathe and do their own thing. After all, what's Sunday for but football? What would we do on Saturday but Saturday Night Live? And what about Friday? Everybody's working for the weekend. Let's this continue long enough and evangelical Protestantism will ripe for a takeover by Rome. The world will invade, and no longer will there be a Christian who says on Sunday morning that he would rather be in church than be on football and the fantasy league or American Idol and what we worship. What is it we worship? Who is it we choose? What are our decisions this day? The Christian gospel is a message of freedom through grace and must stand fast in the liberty wherewith Christ has made us free. But what shall we do with our freedom? Was it a choice of just simply being free that we can do our own thing, go our own way, act our own God-like, or become as gods? I think it might be well for us to check our spiritual condition occasionally by the simple test of compatibility. When we are free to go, where do we go? In what company do we feel most at home? Where do our thoughts turn when they are free to turn whenever or wherever they will? When the pressure of work or business or school has temporarily lifted and we are able to think of what we will do instead of what we must do, what do we think of then? What is your mindset? Are we willing to face up to the answers to these questions, which may tell us more than we comfortably accept? Where do you go? What are you going to do as soon as you're done with your devotional or evotional, and as soon as you're done with Sunday morning church, do you run off to the restaurant and have a nice breakfast and go off to the yard work or some other work? What do we do? What should we do? How should we respond? I think God isn't trying to say to us, don't have fun or don't enjoy yourself, but rather participate with Him in it. Bring God to the equation, and you'll find that He'll bring the process to the culmination. It will accomplish His will if you involve Him in all that you do. And that's all God really wants. He's personal. He wants to be involved in everything you do. But the question is, do you want Him involved in everything you do? That's a good question.